have anyone rise for me, please? Who gives Megan to be married to Trent?
Donna and I do.
Wonderful, Adam. Perfect.
Thank you. Thank you, special.
All right, you may all be seated. Thank you. So on behalf of Megan and Trent, I just want to say thank you and welcome to everyone that is here today. What a beautiful spot, and the weather is cooperating and the wind is calming down a little bit. So let's open in prayer. Father God, thank you for bringing us here today to celebrate the marriage of Trent and Megan. Bless our time together here as we join in unity our love for them and our commitment to support them in their journey as husband and wife. God, thank you for creating the gift of marriage for us to understand you more. For it is by your design that man and woman are the full representation of who you are. Amen.
Amen.
All right. So good afternoon. My name is Kevin Hanna, and I will be officiating this beautiful wedding today. My wife and I met Kim, my wife Kim met Trent and Megan when we were doing marriage mentoring with them through our church, Westgate in San Jose. And as we met with them, my wife and I just became big fans of this couple. We fell in love with them deeply. And then they were crazy enough to say, would you marry us? And so I said, yes, of course. I'm very proud of you guys. Megan and Trent, as we met and talked together, we talked about how it takes commitment and it takes hard work to be committed in a marriage. That when things come in your direction that are challenging, you might have to spend a little time and work together on that challenge, right? So it takes hard work. You learn to work together as a team. You are learning to be quick to listen, slow to speak, and forgiving one another, right? Take time to understand each other and seek the best for one another. For God has designed marriage. You know, looking back, I was trying to find this right moment. Well, God created the heavens and the earth, and then he put man on the earth, and then he asked the man to name all the animals. And when when he was done with that, Adam was like, okay, everything's good. And God said, no, it's not. Adam's going to need a lot of help. In fact, he was probably thinking of you too, because Trent, you're going to need some help. I'm just saying. And I think that he designed a beautiful union with you two, that you are the perfect helpmate to him and you are to her, where you're going to grow and become stronger people because of your union together as one. So keep in mind that it's not the problem, or it's not each other, right? You're not attacking her and she's not attacking you, it's the problem. Let's focus on the problem, come together, solve the problem, and you grow stronger together as one. So keep your love of Jesus Christ at the center of your lives, and this cord of three will not easily be broken. So I asked Trent and Megan to give me some words as a special homework for this ceremony today. And here are the words that they gave me for why they wanted to get married to one another. So these are Megan's. The way he makes me feel. I love how he takes care of me. He is my home and best friend. He is so handsome. She said that. Yes, she did. He is so handsome, I'll never get tired of looking at him and feeling blessed that he is mine. These are some other comments. Well, let's go to you. She said, Trent is easygoing, forgiving, and understanding. The drive and work ethic is something she loves about you. And the sacrifice you make for others to have a good time is something she recognizes you and loves. Now, these are Trent's words to you. Are you ready? Yeah. Okay, here we go. She is my sunshine. Her smile and infectious laugh cut through like a ray of light. She stays upbeat and positive. She loves the Lord. Ultimately, Megan inspires me to be a better person every day and in all I do. I consider myself the luckiest man in the world to be blessed with her as my life partner. And here's some other things you guys said about each other here, right? You both said you're looking forward to having adventures together. So wherever that might be, let's see if you guys make it to the top of a really tall mountain someday together, camping out. You're looking forward to having children and making a family of your own together and standing by each other through life's challenges as you grow and grow old together. Those are the things you gave me in your words. All right, let's get into this a little bit.
Yeah.
Yeah? Megan, will you have this man as to be your husband, to live together in covenant of marriage? Will you love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsake all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Excellent. Trent, will you have this woman to be your wife, to live together in the covenant of marriage? Will you love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Okay, yeah, nice and loud.
Could you say that again? I don't think anybody heard that. All right. Now, you guys have put together your own vows, so I'm going to do this here. Let me give you those.
Thank you.
And these are yours. And, sir, you start.
All right.
You got it, baby.
Megan, today I stand before you still in disbelief that I was chosen by the most kind, caring, goofy, and beautiful woman I've ever met. I stand here before you determined to be the best partner I can be. I promise to work on myself and our relationship every day, striving to be a better version of myself for you. I am grateful for the love and compassion you bring into my life, and I vow to reciprocate that love and compassion always. I promise to be mindful of the little things, whether it's picking out your scrubs for work, planning date nights, weekend trips to the snow, catching a sunset, or making you the world's best sandwich. I will be intentional in continuing to create these moments for us. Together, I know that we will create a love story that is both beautiful and hilarious, and one that will be remembered for generations to come. I vow to honor and respect you as we walk this journey together, knowing that God has brought us together for a purpose. I will cherish you, support you, and nurture our relationship, always seeking God's guidance in every decision we make. I promise to pray for you and with you, to lift you up when you are down, and to rejoice with you in our blessings. But above all, I promise to do my best to always be gentle with your heart and be mindful of how I use my words. So with love in my heart and a smile on my face, I say these vows to you, my partner, my best friend, my forever cheermakes. Let's embark on this incredible journey together, hand in hand, and create a life filled with love, laughter, and a whole lot of passion. I love you.
I love you. That's so good.
Surprised?
No, it was so good.
I think she's in shock right now. It's like, he put those words together?
No, that was amazing.
Well done.
Trent, my honey, my sweetie, my best friend. The day I've dreamed of since I was a little girl. Standing up here with you in front of all of our closest friends and family is so surreal. I've prayed for someone like you, but never did I imagine someone as amazing as you. I truly believe we are meant and made for each other. You are my soulmate. From the moment we met, my whole world changed. I knew you were something special and I'd found my forever. Your smile, your energy, your good looks is what caught my attention. But boy, your heart. That's when I knew I never wanted to ever let you go. You found me at a time where I felt unlovable. You showed me nothing but gentleness, patience, kindness, and what true love looks like. Getting to be loved by you and chosen by you is the greatest gift God has given me. You love all my insecurities. You tell me what I don't want to hear, but need to hear. You truly bring out the best in me and help me become a better person. We make the best power team and even each other out in the best ways possible. I tell you this all the time, but you are the smartest person I know. Always teaching me new words and surprising me with how much you know about every single thing in this world. Even the medical terms and anything about medical, I'm surprised all the time. You have the biggest heart, and the love you have for me, your family, and friends is unmatched. Your smile lights up the room, and your laugh truly makes my heart skip a beat. I'll never get over introducing you to someone, and them coming up to me and telling me you're their new best friend. Sometimes I think my friends like you more than me, but one of my favorite things about you is how you are honest and wholeheartedly yourself. I love that you have strong opinions on things. Even though I might always agree, you're strong-minded and you never give up. Your determination for anything you set your mind to will make you go far. You're one of the hardest working people I know, and your want and dedication to provide for us and our future family is something I'll never take for granted. You're my favorite person to laugh and be silly with, laughing until we literally have tears coming down our face. I could stare into your beautiful eyes all day, and especially when your eyes water, when you're feeling really happy. I'm so proud of the man you are today and what God is continuing to work on you. Your willingness to grow in our faith together is so profound. It's something I know will keep us grounded forever. We have made such a beautiful life together so far, and being in your arms will always be my favorite place. I promise to never forget what a privilege it is to have you as my husband. I promise to remember the weight of my words and to only reserve the sweetest ones for you. I promise to always try my best to clean up after myself in the kitchen when I'm running late to work and not leave my things everywhere. I promise to keep encouraging you and being your biggest cheerleader. I promise to give you your space and alone time when you need it. I promise to be quick to apologize and even quicker to forgive. The grace you give me is truly something I admire, and I promise to try to have the same for you. I promise to be the best mom to our future children and the wife you need me to be. I promise to make our home fun and full of love and laughter. You're the best dog daddy to our Alvin, and I can't even begin to imagine what an amazing dad you'll be to our future children. Becoming your wife today is the best thing to ever happen to me. I love you, and I can't wait to spend the rest of our life together.
I love it. Thank you.
Wow. I'm so glad I didn't try to do the vows, because you guys were awesome. Wow, wonderful. And this is why I kept my part really short, because I loved what you guys just said. Before we go do that candle over there, I just want to say I am very proud of you two, and I'm very proud to be asked to be standing right here with you. We're going to ask them to go light the unity candle now, and hopefully it stays lit for you. Let's go. Yeah. And when you get back, we'll do the rings. That's what I missed. So this unity candle's been in the family a little while. Is it? There we go. Well done, Trent. Well done. Well done. All right. There we go. Megan, you made a really wise choice to ask me, because I was like, if I do this wrong, she's chasing me down this golf course, and I don't want you to be mad at me. So here they are. Wow, beautiful. Let me pull out my notes, because I'm going to get lost right at the moment. So give me a second. So the wedding ring is a symbol of eternity, because the ring has no beginning and it has no end. It is an outward sign of an inward and spiritual bond that you two will have together. So Trent, take this ring and then repeat after me. With this ring, I am giving you a symbol of an everlasting love for you.
With this ring, I'm giving you a symbol of an everlasting love for you.
Love it. Place it on your finger. There you go. All right. Now, the words are not very long, so wait till I'm finished. You can replay it. Okay. Here we go.
It's okay.
Trent, with this ring, I am giving you a symbol of my everlasting love to you.
Trent, with this ring, I'm giving you a symbol of my everlasting love to you.
Nice.
You did it. Now put it on his finger.
Yeah.
All right.
Looks so good.
Let me just add right here. With these rings, you're committing to one another to put up with the good, the bad, and the ugly that comes out of each of you. Now, that was because we're at Clint Eastwood's golf course, in case anybody wanted to know. Clint Eastwood's really happy I said that right now. Let's close in prayer, and then let's go have some fun. So, Heavenly Father, I just want to thank you that you are a God who has a sense of humor and can look down on me right now, trying to struggle through this, and you're smiling. And I also know you're smiling down on Megan and Trent, standing right here before me, and you love your children so much that you put them together. Thank you for bringing Megan and Trent together as they unite here today with you as the center of their lives. Jesus, may you always remind them to remember the sacrifice you made for them to be with you forever. May they keep you in mind when they need to make sacrifices for one another. Holy Spirit, as you live in their hearts, may they remember that there is no challenge in this life they can't walk through without you not giving them the strength for it. May they remember you were always with them and you were always for them. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, bless them as they begin their journey of marriage and bring them peace, love, and happiness. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
I pronounce you man and wife. You may kiss your bride. You want to do that, don't you? Okay, get there. Thank you. All right. Ladies and gentlemen, it's my pleasure to introduce to you for the very first time, Mr. and Mrs. Trent Dexheimer. This will be an everlasting love. This will be the one I've waited for. This will be the first time anyone has loved me. Found me in time, and I'm so glad that you rectified my mind. This will be an everlasting love for me. Loving you is so kind of wonderful, because you've shown me just how much you care. You've given me the thrill of a lifetime and made me believe. My life.